we shall reign in life by one.
You know, at the right hand of God as our high priest, and if he's our high priest forever, it tells us one thing: we are blessed forever. Don't you know that? You are blessed forever. You have to know that. You are blessed forever. Now, open your Bible with me this morning in the book of Romans chapter 5. Siguro we can begin reading on verse 15 na lang. Verse 15, but not as the offense, so also is the free gift. For if through the offense of one, that was Adam, many be dead, much more the grace of God and the gift by grace, which is by one man Jesus Christ, has abounded unto many. And not as it was by one that sinned, so is the gift for the judgment was by one to condemnation. But the free gift is of many offenses unto justification. For if by one man's offense, that was Adam, for if by one man's offense death reigned by one, much more they which receive abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by one, Jesus Christ. Therefore, as the offense of one, judgment came upon all men to condemnation, even so by the righteousness of one, the free gift came upon all men unto justification of life. For as by one man's disobedience, many were made sinners, so by the obedience of one shall many be made righteous. So for the past two Sundays, we have been talking about understanding the righteousness of God. So mahalaga po na bilang mananampalataya, ay maunawaan po natin, magkaroon po tayo ng kapahayagan patungkol po sa tinatawag na righteousness of God. And we found out that it was because of the obedience of Jesus Christ that we were made righteous. And I told you this morning that when it comes to the obedience of Jesus Christ, we have to go back to the cross. Again, doon sa Ephesians or Philippians chapter 2, babalikan po natin. Yung pong binasa po natin kanina, Philippians chapter 2, verse 5. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who, Jesus Christ, being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God. So notice here, binabanggit po doon kung sino si Kristo, sa pasimula pa lamang. Who being, so who refers back to Jesus Christ? As far as his being is concerned, his being is in the form of God. In other words, he was God himself. And Jesus Christ thought it not robbery to be equal with God. In other words, he was equal with God. But when he became a man, he thought it not robbery na kung saan ay palabagang nawalan siya nung siya magkatawang tao. Hindi niya inisip na malaking kawalan sa kanya yung siya ay magkatawang tao. Hindi po niya inisip yun. Na nawala sa kanya ang pagiging Diyos, something like that, and so on and so forth. Okay, who being in the form of God thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation. Next verse, please. But made himself of no reputation, and being found in fashion as a man, okay, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. Next verse, please. And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Now again, pag pinag-usapan po natin yung obedience of Christ, hindi lamang po ito mag-a-apply doon sa kanyang ginawang pagsunod sa kanyang buong buhay sa mundong ito. Of course, Jesus Christ was the only person who perfectly obeyed all the commandments under the law. Amen? But when it comes to the obedience of Jesus Christ, hindi lamang po yun ang dapat po nating makita. Pagdating sa obedience of Christ, at tinutukoy po na obedience of Jesus Christ ay yung kanyang pagsunod sa Ama hanggang doon sa kanyang kamatayan, doon sa krus ng Kalbaryo. Kung inyo po matatandaan, prior to the cross, bago po yung krus ng Kalbaryo, Jesus Christ was praying, you know, with the Father in the Garden of Gethsemane. So naalala niyo ba doon sa Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus Christ was agonizing in prayer, you know, his soul was in sorrow, so to speak, to the point na yung kanya pong pawis na lumabas po sa kanyang katawan ay dugo. You can just imagine that. kay hindi na pawis ang lumabas sa kanyang katawan, kundi literally dugo ang lumabas po sa kanya. So he was in agony and he was telling the Father, "Father, if it is possible to take away this cup of suffering from me, but nevertheless, not my will, but let your will be done." That was the obedience of Jesus Christ. He said, "Nevertheless, not my will, but let your will be done, Father." So Jesus Christ knew that the moment he is crucified on the cross, papasanin po niya at dadalin po niya lahat ng kasalanan ng sangkatauhan. Although it will be, just for a while, pero he knew that he would be separated from the Father on the cross of Calvary. Okay? At alam po niya na siya po ay papasanin niya ang kasalanan po ng buong salibutan. At yun po ang sinasabi ng 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 21. That's how we were made righteous, because of the obedience of Jesus Christ. On the cross, God made him to be sin for us who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. So paano po naging kasalanan si Jesus Christ doon sa krus ng Kalbaryo? How did Jesus Christ become sin? Siya ba'y naging kasalanan dahil siya nakagawa ng pagkakasala? Did Jesus Christ committed an act of sin? That's why he became sin? Of course not. He knew no sin, the Bible tells us. He committed no sin. He not even a single act of sin Jesus Christ did not commit. Amen? Paano siya naging kasalanan? Naging kasalanan po siya, siya'y ginawang kasalanan. In other words, yung ating kasalanan ay napunta sa kanya. Nung ang ating kasalanan ay ipinato kay Jesucristo sa krus ng Kalbaryo, siya ay naging kasalanan. Siya'y naging kasalanan hindi po dahil meron siyang nagawa na pagkakasala. In the same manner, okay, tayo po ay ginawang matuwid ng Diyos. Jesus Christ was made sin so that we might be made the righteousness of God in Him. Paano po tayong naging righteous? Tayo ba'y naging righteous dahil tayo nakagawa ng mga gawaing righteous? Okay, did we become righteous because of our act of righteousness? Of course not. Hindi po tayo naging righteous because of our act of righteousness. Not even a single act of righteousness cannot make us righteous. Are you still with me? So we have been made righteous because Jesus Christ was made sin. Amen? So God made us the righteous of God because of His obedience. So kung tayo po ay ginawang righteous ng Panginoon because of the obedience of Jesus Christ, what makes us think that through our own disobedience, we will become unrighteous? Okay, yung po ang tatalakayin po natin ngayon. Okay? But anyway, so dahil tayo po ginawang righteous dahil sa pagsunod ni Jesus Christ, that matapos tayo maging righteousness of God, na hindi po nahulugan na every time na tayo nakakagawa ng act of unrighteousness, we become unrighteous again. O kaya naman, ay nababawasan yung ating righteousness. Okay? Yan po ang tatalakayin po natin mamaya. But last time, we talk about understanding righteousness. Now, number one, understanding righteousness will cause us to rule and reign in life. So, nakita po natin last time yan. Balikan po natin yung Romans chapter 5, verse 17. Okay? Understanding righteousness causes us to rule and reign in life. How many of you wants to rule and reign in life? Sino po ang nice po na mag-rule and reign? Ruling and reigning over sin, ruling and reigning over poverty and lack, ruling and reigning over sicknesses and diseases, ruling and reigning over any negative situation in life. So how about that? Okay? Now, the Bible tells us, "For if by one man's offense, death reigned by one, that was Adam, how much more they which receive abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by one, Jesus Christ." Amen? So reigning and ruling in life, has nothing to do with achieving a lot of things. We don't reign by achieving a lot of things. Of course, yun po ang pamantayan ng salibutan. Okay, para masabi po nila na tayo po ay successful, tayo po ay matagumpay, kinakailangan magpakita tayo ng napakaraming achievements. Now, there's nothing wrong with achievements. And we need to understand whatever achievements that we have in this life, it is just the fruit of the grace of God that we have in life as believers. Okay, ruling and reigning has something to do with receiving, not achieving. And there are only two things that you need to receive to rule and reign. Number one, abundance of grace. And number two, gift of righteousness. Sabi natin, abundance of grace, gift of righteousness. Now, have you received Jesus Christ into your life? Nagawa mo na bang tanggapin si Kristo sa iyong buhay? Where is Christ right now located in your life? Is Christ in you? Si Kristo ba'y nasa atin na? Now, if Christ is already in you, living and dwelling on the inside of you, you already have these two things. Amen? Abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness. Why? Because these two things, abundance of grace and gift of righteousness, these two things are embodied in one person, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? Now, grace is not just a doctrine. Grace is not just a teaching. Grace is not just a subject in a Bible school. Grace is a person, and his name is Jesus Christ. In John chapter 1, verse 17, the law was given by Moses, but when it comes to grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. Amen? So, si Cristo, the day Jesus Christ came into your life, that was the day that grace and truth came into your life. Not only that, okay, in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 30, we found out that Jesus Christ was made unto us wisdom. So wisdom is a person, okay, and righteousness. Righteousness is a person, and sanctification, holiness. Holiness is a person, and redemption. If you have Christ in you has now become your wisdom. Christ in you has now become your holiness or sanctification. Christ in you has now become your redemption. Christ in you has now become your righteousness. Amen? So you already have these two things in you simply because Christ is in you. God's abundance of grace and God's gift of righteousness. Okay, and the Bible tells us those who receive God's abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness, they shall reign in life. It doesn't say they may probably reign in life. No, the Bible said, Romans 5:17, the Bible said they shall reign in life. Sabi natin, I shall reign in life. Now notice shall, the word shall is one of the strongest words in the Bible. Rather, in the English language. Shall. It didn't say, you may reign in life. It didn't say, probably you may reign in life. It said, once you receive the abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness in the person of Jesus Christ, you shall reign in life. Amen? You shall reign in life by one. I like that. You don't need five things to reign. You don't need 10. You don't need 15. Amen? You don't need the five steps to ruling and reigning. You don't need the 10 principles to ruling and reigning. You don't need the 15 keys to ruling and reigning. Okay? You simply need one. And if you're a believer, you already have that one living and dwelling on the inside of you. His name is Jesus Christ. Amen? Praise God. So don't go out and go to the national bookstore and look for books about five steps or 11 keys to ruling and reigning. You know, those are self-help books. Amen. But you don't need that because you already have the helper living on the inside of you. You don't need a self-help book. You have the helper, the comforter, the Holy Ghost living on the inside of you. Sabihin natin, I am a Holy Ghost help person. Amen? The Holy Spirit is the one helping us. Okay? Now, secondly, we found out that understanding righteousness causes us to mature. Understanding righteousness causes us to mature. Spiritually mature. Amen? The reason why the Hebrew believers, most of them remained baby Christians, nakita po natin, because they were unskillful in the word of righteousness. They were unskillful in the word of righteousness. So, we need to be skillful in the word of righteousness. We found out that the word of righteousness would be equivalent to the gospel of Jesus Christ. And the gospel is all about who Christ is, what he has done, and who we are in him. The more you know who Christ is, the more you know what He has already done through the finished work of the cross, the more you know your identity, who you are in Christ, the more you will grow in the grace of the Lord. Amen? So understanding righteousness causes us to mature spiritually. And lastly, we found out that understanding righteousness makes us conscious of righteousness instead of sin and condemnation. Makes us conscious of righteousness instead of sin and condemnation. So we need to grow in grace until we are more righteousness of God conscious rather than sin and condemnation conscious. So yung pinaka, ito po ang prevailing problem in the body of Christ. Most believers are sin and condemnation conscious rather than righteousness conscious. So yung po problema po na maraming mananampalataya. Okay? They are more sin conscious rather than righteousness conscious. You know what? Okay? God told us that in this new covenant, God said, you know, in this new covenant that I will have with you, in this new covenant, and this is the main clause of the new covenant, He said, I will remember your sins no more. God Himself is no more conscious of your sins. Are you still with me? Okay, now let's go on. So today, ang pag-uusapan po natin ay, yes, Pastor, I'm glad to know that. Yes, I am now the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus because of what He has done. I am now a new creation in Christ. But what if next day I commit sin? What if I commit mistake? What if I do this and I do that? Will I remain righteous? Or baka, you know, mabawasan ang aking righteousness? So, yung pong kaisipan po ng marami sa body of Christ ay nando po sa kaisipan na kung saan marami po ay naniniwala na matapos tayong maligtas, totoo na tayo pinatawad sa ating kasalanan, tayo po'y ginawang righteous, but kapag ka tayo nagkamali, every time na tayo nagkakamali, every time na tayo nagkakasala, ay kung hindi man tayo po'y nagiging unrighteous muli, at least nababawasan yung ating righteousness. Yung dating 100% righteousness, probably naging 95% na lang, o naging 80% na lang, something like that. So kinakailangan, ito po ay maging malinaw po sa atin. Kasi kung ganun po ang ating pranaw, we are still having that old covenant mindset. Okay, na ito po ay self-righteousness. And last Sunday, I shared with you about self-righteousness. This is very important. Minsan kasi nakafocus lang tayo doon sa kasalanan. Okay, na marami po nasasabi that the default system of humanity is sin. And that is true to a certain extent. Amen? But we found out that when Adam fell, when Adam partook of the fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil in the Garden of Eden, and we call that, you know, as the fall of Adam, when he fell, not only Adam fell into sin, Adam fell into self-righteousness. Now, I can still remember, maybe 3 or 4 years ago, I was invited to be a speaker in a church anniversary somewhere in Quezon City. And, you know, I spoke these words, and I said, you know what, when Adam fell in the Garden of Eden, not only Adam became a sinner, yun po ang alam po ng lahat, na si Adam ay naging makasalanan. But I said something that you know, that was revolutionary, so to speak. Now maybe I ilan lamang po ang mapapakinggan po natin. I said, you know, not only Adam became a sinner the moment he partook of the fruit of the tree, from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, Adam became religious. Okay, and then I saw the pastor, you know, the pastor was nodding, yeah, that's the truth. Okay, and then I think that was one of the keys, na one of the truth na kung saan I, you know, he went back to his Bible, and then after that, he embraced, he received the revelation of the gospel of grace, and right now, he is a pure grace pastor. Amen? Now, that is true. And then this morning I shared about, you know, what happened the moment Adam partook of the fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Of course, he died spiritually because God told Adam, in the day that you eat thereof, you shall surely die. And God was not referring to spirit, to physical death. In the day, Adam, that you eat thereof, you shall surely die. And God was referring to his spiritual death. Okay, paano ito? But God was referring to the end result of Adam's disobedience. But you know what? The moment Adam partook of the fruit, Adam became self-righteous. And self-righteousness gave birth to sin. And sin resulted to spiritual death. Now, this is not a process. Don't get me wrong. Hindi po ito process na it take, you know, after 3 days, you know, Adam became self-righteous. But after a day, you know, the next day he became a sinner. And then after quite some time, he was separated from God. He died spiritually. No, no, no. You know, now that was an instant. Not just for the sake of study. Ito po ay ating pinag-uusapan. He became self-righteous, and self-righteousness gave birth to sin, and sin resulted in separation from God. Yung po nangyari the day Adam partook of the fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Now go with me to 1 Corinthians chapter 15. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 55. Okay, tingnan po natin. Oh, death, where is your sting? Oh, grave, where is your victory? Verse 56. The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. Now, underline 3 words here. Death, sin, law. Makita natin ang pinaka-root dito ay yung law. Amen? The sting of death. Ang kamandag ng kasalanan, ang kamatayan, spiritual death, is sin. In other words, sin resulted in death. Pero hindi lamang po sin ang binabanggit dito. The strength of sin is the law. So, ang pinakapunot dulo nito ay yung pong law. Amen? Law. At pamilya tayo sa law of Moses. Pamilya tayo sa Ten Commandments. At kung pipinan po natin, yung Ten Commandments po ay nahati lamang sa dalawa. Thou shall and thou shall not. Amen? Thou shall and thou shall not. Okay? Thou shall and thou shall not. Now, ano pong ibig sabihin nito? It tells us one thing, that the law originated from the Garden of Eden. The law originated from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Amen? Now, once Adam gained knowledge of good and evil. Knowledge of good, now balikan natin ang Ten Commandments. Okay, thou shall not. Amen? Now, saan po yung thou shall? Okay? Yung knowledge of good. Saan po pwedeng ilagay yung knowledge of good? Once you gain knowledge of good, then the law would say, thou shall do the good. Amen? Once you gain the knowledge of evil, the law will say, thou shall not do evil. Amen? Okay, honoring your parents is good. Thou shall honor your parents. Worshipping God is good. Thou shalt worship the Lord your God. Amen? Adultery is evil. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Lying is evil. Thou shalt not lie. So, that's the law. At galing po yan doon sa a tree of the knowledge of good and evil. So, yun po nangyari. Now, lahat po ng religion, the reason why I said Adam became religious, because all religion ay umiikot lamang po doon. Lahat po ng relihiyon, meron silang kanya-kanyang thou shall, tsaka thou shall not. Amen? May kanya-kanya silang thou shall. Meron silang kanya-kanyang opinion kung ano yung good, kung ano yung evil. Kaya lang, ang problema, yung good sa isang relihiyon, evil naman doon sa kabilang relihiyon. Halimbawa, it is evil for the Muslims to eat pork. Okay? But it is okay for them to eat beef. Okay sa kanila po ay evil yung pong kumain po ng baboy, pero okay lang na kumain ng baka. Sa mga Hindus naman, hindi pwede kumain ng baka. Dahil ginawa Diyos na yung baka. It will be evil for you to eat beef. Pero okay sa kanila yung pork. So, something like that. So, yung purilihiyo, may kanya-kanya silang listahan kung ano yung mabuti, kung ano yung masama, at yung mabuti, gawin mo, yung masama, huwag mong gawin. That's religion. Are you still with me? So, mas pinili po ni Adan yung pong relasyon sa Diyos na kung saan ang kanyang relationship with God ay nakabase doon sa kanyang pagsunod at sa kanyang pagsunod sa batas. Pinili po yun ni Adan. Amen? Okay? Now, that's self-righteousness. And self-righteousness gave birth to sin, and sin leads to spiritual death. Okay, now let's go on. So, with that background, so anong gagawin natin? The question is, now that we are believers, now that we are the righteous of God, okay, what shall we do? Kapag tayo ay nagkamali, na isang bagay po ang dapat po natin maunawaan. Committing sin. If you are a believer, you know, we don't want to commit sin anymore. Amen. God is against sins. You know, later on we'll find out that even, you know, the Apostle Paul and John, the beloved, they were against sin. I am against sin. You know, we are against sin. Pero may pagkakataon po na tayo nagkakamali. Now, ito po ang dapat nating maunawaan. Committing sin, if you are a believer, committing sin doesn't make you unrighteous again. Committing sin doesn't make you unrighteous again. You may fall into sin, but it doesn't make you unrighteous again. Amen? Naalala ko, I made this illustration this morning. Naalala ko nung araw, nung ako'y bata pa doon sa probinsya po namin, during my elementary days, ay kami po mga magkakalaro ay madalas po kaming, you know, pumupunta po sa mga medyo bukid, yung medyo bundok, at meron po kaming dalang tirador at yun po mga laruan namin. Pasensya na po kayo, yun lang ang kaya namin laruin ng araw. Wala pang Angry Birds ng araw, wala pang mga PS3 at PS4, you know. Kaya yun laro namin, outdoor talaga. At naalala ko po na meron po kami tinatawid na mga ilog, hindi naman kalakihan, hindi naman kalaparan, mga ilog. At pagkatapos po, para matawid po yun, maglalagay lang po sila ng isang pinutol na kahoy ng nyog, puno ng nyog, doon kami tatawid. Iba naman, kawayan, tatawid kami yun. Talagang kinakailangan, maingat ka sa pagtawid. Kaya sukbit ko yung aking, you know, yung aking tirador, tapos may mga bato ako sa bulsa, tatawid akong ganyan. Okay? May mga pagkakataon po na meron sa aming bumapaksak dun sa ilog. Okay? Pero wala pa akong natandaan, nakalaro ko, nung bumaksak sa ilog, naging isda. Amen? Hindi po ang isa bumaksak sa ilog, siya ay naging isda. O naging hito. O naging dalag. Hindi po. Amen? So, ganun din po tayo. So, maaari tayo bumaksak, pero hindi nangangalaga tayo magiging makasalanan muli pag tayo bumaksak. Amen? So, in other words, kung kasakali ikaw ay madulas sa tulay, bulaglag ka sa ilog, you are still a human being. You don't become a fish. Simply because you fall into the waters. You don't become a fish. All you need to do is get out of the water. Amen? Nalala ko nung kami po ni Pastor Ronnie and some friends, last Monday, we went to Anilao, Batangas. And then we went scuba diving. And nakadalawang dives po kami. And then yung second dive po namin, that was one of my favorite dive spot in Anilao. Yung pong tinatawag na cathedral. Tinawag po itong cathedral simply because the former President Ramos, nagpalagay po siya ng cross doon po sa isang spot doon, at ito po ay tinubuan na ng corals. You know, that was many years ago, even before he became president. He was already a scuba diver, and I've heard a story that one time he was in a helicopter. Siya po ay nasa Philippine Constabulary pa nung araw. Doon pa lamang sa helicopter, sinuot niya na ang kanyang scuba diving gear, hindi na siya makatiis, you know, at from the helicopter, tumalong po siya, diretso tubig, nag-scuba diving. Okay, something like that. So, siya po ang naglagay ng cross. Of course, we know that FDR, Fidel Ramos, the former president, is a believing Christian. So, nagpalagay siya ng cross doon, and that is one of our favorite dive sites in anilaw, pag dumating, pagka lumalapit ka palang po doon sa krus na yon, ay nilalapitan ka ng sangkaterbang mga isda. Kasi nasanay po sila sa fish feeding. At sangkaterbang isda, thinking na may dala kami pagkain. At napakarami pong isda. That was, yung cross po ay nasa 60 feet na depth. Mga 6-story building. 60 feet na anlalim. So, doon po kami na Pastor Ronnie. Mukha po kami na. Now, mga 45 minutes po kami sa aming dive. 40, 45 minutes. But niminsan, dahil kasama ko na yung mga isda, nalwalang, you know, nakipaglaro kami sa mga sangkaterbang isda, color, iba't ibang kulay, iba't ibang klaseng isda. But niminsan, hindi sumagi sa isip ko, teka muna, 40 minutes na kami dito ni na Pastor. Baka, naging isda na rin ako. Of course not. Amen? Kahit na 40, 45, you know, sometimes more than 1 hour pa kami sa ilalim ng tubig, it doesn't turn us to become fish. Amen? Okay? So, ganoon din po tayo. So, kapag ganoon pong katagal, we have to watch our air, yung air consumption. Kasi alam namin, hindi kami pwede magtagal sa ilalim ng tubig, kinakailangan, yung aming air consumption, dapat meron pong yung aming tangke ng air ay dapat merong air. Kung hindi, wala. Okay? So wala pa po ako nakita katulad na ng aming kaibigan Singaporean, yung scuba diver instructor po namin, nakaka 10,000 dives na po siya sa kanyang buong buhay. More than 10,000 dives. And yet, tinitingnan ko po yung kanyang leeg, hindi pa po siya tinutubuan ng ano tawag doon? Hasang. Okay? With 10,000 dives. You can just imagine that. So in other words, sisters, you may fall into water, but does that mean that you will become a fish? You are still a human being. All you need to do is to get out of the water. Kami naman mga scuba diver, all you need to do is to get out of the water before we run out of air. Amen? So in other words, brothers and sisters, you may fall into sin or whatever, but it doesn't make you unrighteous again. You are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Amen? Praise God. Come on, just bless the Lord. Okay? Glory to God. Now, anong gagawin natin? If ever na tayo po ay magkasala, sasagutin po natin yan later on. Saan bagay po dapat natin maunawaan? Na dalawang klaseng tao lamang po meron sa mundong ito. Those who are still in Adam and those who are now in Christ. Now, 2 Corinthians chapter 15. 2 Corinthians chapter 15. Of 1 Corinthians, I should say. 1 Corinthians 15. We'll just read verse 22 for the sake of time. Then we'll go to the other scriptures. For us in Adam, all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. So notice the tenses. I want you to underline two phrases here. In Adam, sabi natin in Adam. In Christ, sabi natin in Christ. There are only two kinds of people on earth today. Those who are still in Adam and those who are now in Christ. Amen? So, yun po. So, those who are still in Adam, they shall all die. Those who are now in Christ shall all be made alive. So, this is talking about our future physical resurrection body. If you are in Christ, you shall be made alive. You shall have your future physical resurrected body. It's another message. Amen? That's still in the future. But we need to understand that even our future physical glorified body is already paid for by the blood of Jesus Christ. Kasama na po yan sa binayaran ng dugo ni Kristo krus ng Kalbaryo. Ang tawag po yan ay our purchase, binayaran, past tense, possession. Amen? And we will not go into that. Okay? Now, there are only two kinds of people on earth, those who are still in Adam and those who are now in Christ. You know what? Jesus Christ came, He died, and rose again, not only to deliver you from sin and translate you into His righteousness. He came, He died, He rose again, not only to deliver you from spiritual death and translate you into eternal life. Okay? He came, He died, and rose again to deliver you from Adam and translate you into Christ. The moment you are delivered from Adam, automatic, you have been delivered from spiritual death. You have been delivered from sin. You have been delivered from the kingdom of darkness. So Jesus Christ came, He died and rose again to deliver us from the fallen Adam. Amen? So nung tayo po'y pinanganak sa mundong ito, physically, we were all born in Adam. But thank God, when we got born again, we got out of Adam and we get into Christ. You are no longer in Adam. You are now in Christ. Amen? Sabihin natin, I am no longer in Adam. I am now in Christ. Okay, now let's go on. In the book of Galatians, chapter 3, verse 28. Galatians 3:28. There is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither bond nor free, there is neither male nor female, for you are all one in Christ. Notice that? Are you in Christ? So in Christ, there is neither Jew nor Greek. In Christ, there is neither bond nor free. In Christ, there is neither male nor female. We are all one in Christ. So being in Christ will be the greatest equalizer. Kasi kay Kristo, tayong na kay Kristo, hindi na pinag-uusapan dito yung ating social status. Kay ikaw ay dating Hudyo o dating ay Hintil. Big deal sa kanila nung araw yan. Hindi na pinag-uusapan dito yung kung ikaw ay empleyado o ikaw yung employer. Okay? So, don't identify yourself based on what they say. Amen? There is no class A and B and C and D and E in Christ. In Christ, we are all class AAA. Amen. Praise God. So being Christ is the greatest equalizer. Okay? Kaya ikako, kaya ang believer po, hindi po nahulugan na, ay, itong mananampalataya na ito, itong born again Christian na ito, itagayayala labang. Siguro class A yung kanyang righteousness. At itong born again believer na ito ay nasa gilid lang ng alabang. Siguro class E lang ang kanyang righteousness. There's no such thing as class A righteousness, class E righteousness. We have the same righteousness, the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Remember that. Amen? Praise God forevermore. Okay? Hallelujah. Now, in Ephesians chapter 2, I just want to give you a background on this letter by the Apostle Paul. This letter was written probably in 63, 64 AD, and that will be 30 years after the resurrection. That will be 30 years. And he was writing to the local church. So we can assume that in any given local church, there will always be young people. Amen? Now, at least 30 years old and below. So doon sa local church na yon, ay may mga young people, at least 30 years old and below. So wag na tayo pumunta sa children church ngayon. So sino po ang narito na kayo po ay 30 years old and below? Thou shall not lie, okay? Be honest. 30 years old and below, okay? So a lot of you, okay? So meron tayo hindi lang 30 years old and below, meron tayo mga bata as children's church. Ganon din po sa Ephesian church. Yung pong kausap dito ni Pablo, ay marami sa kanila, maybe at least more than half of them were 30 years old and below. In fact, in Ephesians chapter 6 verse 1, tinawag silang little children, some of them. Children, obey your parents in the Lord. For this is right. So, children were included in the church. Amen? Okay, bakit po ito'y binibigyan ko ng emphasis? Because in Ephesians chapter 2 verse 1, he said, rather chapter 2 verse 1, and you, and he was addressing the entire church, okay, including those who were 30 years old and below. Sino po yung 30 years old and below dito sa church na ito? Those people who were born after the cross. Kung sila'y pinanganak after the cross, and this was written 30 years after the cross, so they would be 30 years old and below. Amen? And you has He made alive who were dead in trespasses and sins. Notice, Paul didn't say, and you, okay, except if you were born after the cross, No, there's no exemption. And you, everybody. And that will include those who were born after the cross. You were dead in trespasses and sins. You were spiritually dead in trespasses and sins. Verse 2. Wherein in time past you walk according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. So, tinawag silang children of disobedience. Next, among whom also we all, that would include the children, those who are 30 years old and below, whom also we all had our conversation in time past in the lust of the flesh, the fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature. In other words, it was our nature, original nature, and were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. Even when we were, okay, verse 4. And were by nature the children of wrath, the previous verse. Okay. Yeah. Children, even as others. Okay. So in other words, ay, nais ko lang pong basagin ang isang maling doktrina. Yung pong doktrina po na inclusionism tsaka universalism. Ito po ang kanilang paniniwala na the Adamic race ended on the cross. Okay? Yung paniniwala po nila. The Adamic race ended on the cross. Meaning to say, after the cross, everybody that is born after the cross, they were born automatically in Christ. Meaning to say, after the cross, lahat ang ipinanganak, automatic, in Christ na, ligtas na sila. Well, it doesn't sound like it is true. Amen? Because these people, many of them were born after the cross, and yet Paul said, you were spiritually dead because of your sin. Everybody, even until today, nung una tayo pinanganak, regardless of our religious background, ang iba po sa atin ay pinanganak tayo, kinagisnan po natin na tayo mga Katoliko. Ang iba sa atin, pinanganak tayo, kinagisnan natin tayo mga Protestante, whatever. You know, but the truth is, kinun tayo pinanganak sa mundong ito, lahat tayo pinanganak in Adam. Okay? We were all born in Adam. There's something wrong with our first birth. That's why we must be born again. But the day we got born again, we got out of Adam, we get into Christ. We are no longer in Adam, we are now in Christ Jesus. Amen? How did it happen? Okay? We become in Christ the moment we believe. Kung tuloy-tuloy po natin hanggang verse 8 and 9. You know, verse 5. But God, who is rich in mercy, wherewith He loved us, even when we were dead in sins, has made us alive together with Christ. By grace, you are saved. That is true. And has raised up together with Christ and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Verse 7, that in the ages to come, He might show the exceeding riches of His grace and His kindness toward us through Christ. Verse 8, for by grace are you saved through faith and that of ourselves. We were saved not only by grace, we were saved by grace through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? Di natin pwedeng paghiwalayin po yung grace and faith. Okay? Yung iba po ay inaalis na po sa equation of faith. So we have been saved by grace. Whether you believe or not, you are already saved because you were born after the cross. That's inclusionism and that is universalism. And I want to tell you that is pure heresy. And we don't subscribe to that. Amen? We have been saved by the grace of God through the finished work of the cross, but we have been saved through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? We become in Christ the day we believe that God has raised Him from the dead. Amen? Come on, just bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Now the question is, what if I commit sin? What shall I do? Now, go to 1 John. Simple lang yan. Pag nagkasala ka, balikan mo yung 1 John. Well, I know, Pastor, you know, what you're saying is 1 John chapter 1, verse 9. No, I didn't say that. Sabi ko lang 1 John. Hindi ko sinabing 1 John chapter 1. Okay, 1 John chapter 2. Okay? Because chapter 1 was written not for you. John, the beloved, wrote the first chapter and he was addressing the Gnostics, the unbelieving Gnostics. Are you a Gnostic? Are you a Gnostic? Of course not. My little children, these things write I unto you that you sin not. First of all, maliwanag po yan, John the beloved was against sin. He said, "My little children, these things write I unto you, that you do not sin." If John was against sin, then God is against sin. Okay? So don't get us wrong. We are not condoning sin. We are not, you know, we are not propagating sin. We are not giving people license to sin. And if any man sin, as much as we don't want to sin anymore, because your inner man, the born again man, doesn't want to commit sin anymore. But if anyone sin, we have. Sabi natin, I have. Remember that. If anyone sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous. Okay? We have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous. That's one thing. Jesus Christ is our righteousness. Not only He is at the right hand of God, we are seated with Him at the right hand of God. He is our righteousness. He is living on the inside of us. Okay? Remember that. So, the moment you commit sin, okay, remember Jesus Christ is your righteousness. Now tell me, okay? Now, tuwing nagkakasala ba tayo? Tuwing tayo ba yung nagkakamali? Naapektuhan ba yung righteousness of Jesus? Nababawasan ba yung righteousness of Jesus? Dahil sa ating pagkakamali? Dahil sa ating pagkakasala? Of course not. Amen? And He is our righteousness. We're not talking about our own righteousness based on what we do. Our righteousness is the gift of righteousness. And Christ is our righteousness. Okay? Remember that. Christ is your righteousness. So the moment you sin, you give the Lord, thank you, Lord God, that I don't have my own righteousness. Yes, God, what I did was wrong. It was wrong, Lord. I don't have to do that. Okay? It was wrong. But I thank you that Christ in me is my righteousness. Amen. So remember Jesus. Remember Him. Remember Jesus Christ. He is your righteousness. Amen. Well, Pastor, hindi ba tuwing tayo nagkakamali, you know, we fall into sin. We fell from grace into sin. Now, are you in Christ? I said, are you in Christ? Now, when we fall, whatever it is, okay, when we fall in Christ. Now, I like this. In the Old Testament, we have the Noah's Ark. Now, Noah's Ark was a beautiful picture of Jesus Christ. Ito po'y napaka magandang larawan po ni Kristo, yung Noah's Ark. Lahat lamang po na nasa loob ng arko, sila'y naligtas. So tayo po'y nasa loob ng arko, so to speak. We are in Christ. So we are saved. Amen? Pero tingnan po natin. Ay ilang araw din po sila doon sa loob ng arko. Si Noah, ang kanyang asawa, yung tatlong anak ni Noah at kanyang mga asawa, at yung mga paris-paris na hayop. And we need to understand that outside of the ark, okay, meron pong matinding bagyo. Malakas ang hangin at malakas ang ulan. And then, of course, we can assume na habang tumataas yung tubig, lumalakas po yung alon. At kung nasubukan nyo na po na kayo po ay sumakay ng barko, malakas ang alon, you know, at alam nyo po, naintindihan nyo po ang aking ibig sabihin. Na hindi mo maiwasan na yung asawa po halimbawa ni Noah ay maglakad doon po sa loob ng arko dahil kinakailangan po niya magluto din ng mga gulay na, at maaring mga prutas para kumain po ang kanyang pamilya. O si Noah mismo ay kinakailangan meron po siyang gawin. So, hindi maiwasan na sila po yung maglakad sa loob ng arko. At dahil po malakas ang alon, malakas ang hangin, you know, we can assume, okay, na paminsan-minsan sila'y bumabaksak. Okay, paminsan-minsan sila po ay nauumpog. Paminsan-minsan sila'y nadadapa. Are still with me? Ang tanong ko. Okay? Ibig ba sabihin dahil sila'y nadapa, sila'y bumaksak, sila'y nauntog, ibig ba sabihin nung sila'y nadapa sila, lumabas sila ng arko? Hindi po. Naroon pa rin sila sa loob ng arko. Okay? Are still with me? So, maaring meron pong consequences yung kanilang pagbagsak. Maaring meron pong consequences yung kanila pong pagkadapa, maaaring sila'y nasugatan o maaaring, you know, sila'y nabukulan or whatever, meron consequences. We don't condone sin. Meron pong horizontal consequences. Sin may destroy your relationship. Sin may destroy your ministry. Sin may destroy your career. and so on and so forth. So God is against sin. But my point is, hindi porke tayo nagkamali at nagkasala, eh, tayo lalabas na muli kay Kristo at si Kristo lalabas sa atin. Of course not. Amen? So we need to understand that. Okay? Now, go with me this time to 1 John chapter 3, verse 20. Because this is verse 19 and verse 20. And I will end with this. Now in Romans chapter 8, verse 1. Are you familiar with that? Romans chapter 8, verse 1. The Bible said there are now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Are you in Christ Jesus? Amen. If you are in Christ Jesus, there is now no more condemnation for you. Now, in 1 John chapter 3, verse 19, John was saying, and hereby we know that we are of the truth and shall assure our hearts before Him. In other words, ito po yung katotohanan, ito yung mahalagang maunawaan po natin. This truth, once we understand this truth will give us assurance in our hearts before God. Amen. Every time you pray, you can have that confidence and assurance before God. And so on and so forth. Now, what is this truth that we need to understand? Verse 20. For if our heart condemns us, God is greater than our heart, and God knoweth all things. So, ano po yung katotohanan po na dapat natin maunawaan? As believers, it is not God who condemns us. As believers, it is our own heart that condemns us. Okay? Ano po itong ating po sariling heart? It will refer to the unrenewed mind. Our soul, our heart, our unrenewed mind will condemn us. And if our heart condemns us, God is greater than our heart and knoweth all things. Verse 21. But if our heart condemns us not, then we have confidence toward God. So in other words, you know, don't let your own heart condemn you. A lot of believers are living in self-condemnation. Okay, you don't need, to a lot of believers, to majority of believers, they don't need the devil to condemn them. Because they are already condemning themselves. Amen? So, hindi lang po natin kinakailangan Diablo para i-condemn tayo. Of course, the devil is there to condemn you. But to a lot of believers, they don't even need the devil to condemn them because they are already condemning themselves. Don't condemn yourselves. Don't let the devil condemn you. If you're a believer, there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Amen? God will not condemn you. Why? Because all condemnation already fell on Jesus Christ on the cross. Lahat po ng condemnation na nauukol sa ating kasalanan, si Jesus Christ lahat ang tumanggap niyan. Amen? Okay? So there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. I will end with this story. You are familiar with this. In John chapter 8, there was this woman caught in the act of adultery. And you still remember that story? The woman caught in the very act of adultery. And under the law of Moses, remember, that was prior to the cross. Jesus Christ and the rest of the people that were there, they were still under the law of Moses. Okay? They were still under the old covenant of law. And then the Pharisees and all these, self-righteous religious leaders, they brought this woman to Jesus. At tinan po lang kung anong sasabihin po ni Jesus. Okay? Because under the law of Moses, this woman, under the law, caught in adultery, shall be put to death by stoning. Okay? So, dinala kay Jesus Christ yung pong woman caught in adultery. But of course, it takes two to commit adultery. Bakit yung woman lang, wala yung man? Sabi ng iba, siguro, one of the Pharisees was the man. Anyway, tinala na Jesus Christ, according to the law of Moses, this woman should be stoned to death. Okay, the law of Moses commanded us that she should be stoned. But what sayest thou? Okay, ito sinabi ni Moses, but you, Jesus, what do you say? So, tinatrap po nila si Jesus. Now, Jesus Christ, sabi po niya, kung sino sa inyo na narito na hindi nagkasala, let him throw the first stone. Ano sinabi ni Jesus Christ? Okay, dinivert niya. Kasi lahat ng tao, nakafocus sa kasalanan ng babae. Sabi ni Jesus Christ, okay, sino sa inyo ang hindi nagkasala? Siya ang pumukol ng unang bato. So this time, mula doon sa kasalanan ng babae, binalik niya sa mga tao. Sino sa inyo dito ang hindi nagkasala? The Bible tells us, isa-isa, mula sa pinakamatanda hanggang pinakabata, nag-alis ang pulahan. Sabi nila, bakit yung mula sa pinakamatanda? Kasi matatanda, mas marami silang kasalanan. Kumpara sa mga bata. I would agree to a certain degree, to a certain extent. You know, I could say that, you know, the older people, they have more wisdom compared to the younger people. Okay? Now, nawala po lahat, nag-alis ang pulahan. And then, naiwan po si Jesus Christ tsaka yung pong babae. Now, go to that particular verse. Naiwan po si Jesus Christ tsaka yung babae. Sabi ni Jesus Christ, where are your accusers? Ang sabi ng babae, you know, okay, no, the previous one. When Jesus had lifted up himself and saw none but the woman, he said unto her, woman, where are those your accusers? Has no man condemned you? He said, no man. Nawala na silang lahat. Okay? Now listen to this. Si Jesus Christ lamang po ang hindi nagkasala sa kanila. Siya lamang po ang qualified para pumukol ng bato sa babae. Okay? Pero hindi ginawa ni Jesus Christ yan. Amen? Now notice what Jesus Christ said. Okay, I want you to see this. I want you to read this. Go and sin no more, and I will not condemn you. Is that what Jesus Christ said? Go and sin no more, I will not condemn you. Okay? Hindi po. Ang sabi ni Jesus Christ, neither I condemn you. Go and sin no more. Hindi po yung go and sin no more, and I will not condemn you. Okay? Yan po yung relihiyon. Go and sin no more, magpakita ka na ikaw ay nagbago na, magpakita ka na ikaw ay hindi na nagkakasala, hindi ka na namin i-condemn. Pero magpakita ka muna na nagbago ka na. Hindi po ganun. Sabi ni Jesus, neither do I condemn you. Go and sin no more. Amen? Now in this study, we have been familiar with the gift of righteousness. There's another gift that I want you to be familiar with. Not only the gift of righteousness, this woman received the gift of no condemnation. Amen? And receiving the gift of no condemnation will empower you to go and sin no more. I said, the gift of no condemnation will empower you to go and sin no more. Come on, just bless the Lord. So don't let the devil condemn you. And don't condemn yourself, please. Amen? Because God will never condemn you anymore. Hallelujah. You receive the gift of righteousness. And once you receive the gift of righteousness, you receive the gift of no condemnation. Yes, we may commit mistakes. Yes, we may commit, you know, some sin along the way. Although we don't want to sin anymore. It's okay. In any given healthy relationship, it's okay, Father, I blew it. Father, you know, I'm sorry, Father. I don't have to do that anymore. I'm the righteous of God. But remember Jesus Christ, not only at the right of the Father, He's living and dwelling on the inside of you, and He is your righteousness. At yung tanong po sa Romans chapter 8, who will condemn us? Not Jesus. Not God. Amen? Tingnan po natin. I will end with that. Romans chapter 8. I just remember this scripture. Verse 31. If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall God not with him, Jesus, also freely give us how many things? All things. Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? Sino po ang mag-accuse sa atin? To the charge of God's elect. Is it God that justifies? Is it God that made you righteous? Of course not. Who is he that condemns? Sino magpaparusahan? Sino magkocondemn sa atin? Is it Christ that died? Yea, rather, that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us? Of course not. Jesus Christ will never condemn you. God will never accuse you. And He will never condemn you. Amen? So, don't let the devil condemn you. The devil has no right to condemn you. Amen? The devil has no right to condemn you. And please, don't condemn yourself. Praise God. You learn something today? Come on, just bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Woo, glory to God.
Thank you so much for joining us today. And if you have been blessed by today's message, we would like to give you an opportunity to partner with us through your gifts and offerings. You may visit our website at www.jfcf.org for more information. And always remember that with the abundance of God's grace, we can reign in life through Jesus Christ.